Welcome back everyone, I'm Theo Cho, and today's video is all about the new version of iOS, which is iOS 11. But even if you don't have an iPhone, you still might find this interesting if you've been curious about some features that iPhone has, like if you use Android. So I'm gonna tell you what I think are the 11 best features on iOS 11 in no particular order. As usual, before we jump in, I wanna give a quick 2 second shout out to my Instagram where I try to post really cool pictures and sometimes funny stuff too. If you wanna check that out, my username is just @TheoJo and the link is in the description. So without further ado, let's go. Starting off, this one might not seem like a very flashy, exciting feature at first, but I think it's a big deal, and that is the new image and video file formats iOS 11 supports. iPhones will now have the option to take pictures in the so-called High Efficiency Image Format, or HEIF, and videos can be recorded in the H.265 codec. These formats allow pictures and videos to be stored with both higher quality and smaller file sizes, so they're better in almost every way. The only downside is these file formats are still relatively new and haven't had widespread adoption yet. So unless your other devices support these formats, they might have to be converted before viewing them elsewhere. But now that Apple has implemented these formats, I don't think it will be long before all the other devices will be updated to support them as well if they know a lot of people are gonna be actually using them. Moving on, number two is the ability to customize the control center, which is that dashboard you get to by swiping up from the bottom of the screen. Go to Settings, Control Center, then Customize Controls, and you'll see a list of shortcut functions you can choose from. You can add or remove them from the included list, and those will appear at the bottom of the control center if you include them. Of course, you can also drag and arrange them however you want. There are a pretty good amount of options to choose from here, but they all appear to only be official shortcuts built into iOS, not from third-party apps. So stuff like Flashlight, the calculator, HomeKit, and others. But I am hoping that they will let third-party apps add widget shortcuts in the future. It seems like an obvious next step. On to number three, this one is actually really cool, I think, and it is that you can now share your Wi-Fi password with friends or someone else near you without actually giving them your password. Wait, how does that even make sense? What happens is when you want to join someone else's network, instead of typing in the Wi-Fi password, you can now simply hold up your iOS device to another device that is connected to the network. That person will get a prompt asking if they want to allow you to connect, and then you're done. So this is obviously great for a couple reasons, like if you have a nice long Wi-Fi password for security, but it would take forever to type in, or if you just don't want people knowing your password. One thing to know though is both devices must have iOS 11 installed or it won't work. And also both devices need to be unlocked at the same time as well, but that does make sense. Next up, this one is pretty straightforward, but the camera app is now able to scan QR codes, so no more third-party apps are required. Literally, all you do is open up the camera app and point it at a QR code, and then a notification will pop up with what it is. There are several possible functions, whether it's just plain text, or a website link, or even a calendar event, and you can even make a QR code with your Wi-Fi credentials, so just like the previous one, it makes it easy for people to connect without needing to even get your phone. On the other hand, if you want to disable this feature, you can do so right through the camera settings. Number five, this one is going to make a lot of people happy. It's a new setting that you can choose to stop apps from requesting ratings. So no more obnoxious spammy pop-ups telling you to leave a review, completely interrupting everything. To enable this, you go to Settings, iTunes and App Store, then scroll down to In-App Ratings and Reviews and disable that. Now keep in mind, if an app hasn't been updated recently, it might not support this setting and it might still happen. But going forward, Apple is requiring developers to honor this function. I believe they also started restricting how often apps can request reviews even if the person didn't disable them altogether, but they might have done that before iOS, but just keep that in mind, it's cool as well. Okay, number six. Apple has now integrated Apple Pay directly into iMessage, so you can actually send money to your friends without having to go through any third-party apps like Venmo or PayPal. This feature will be called Apple Pay Cash and will appear in your Apple Wallet as a virtual debit card. and you'll also be able to withdraw funds from that account into your bank account. Now, don't get too excited though, because Apple hasn't actually activated this feature yet, but they say it's coming soon in the fall. So depending on when you're watching this video, it might not actually be out yet. Next up, another camera feature is filters. Obviously, this is nothing groundbreaking. Other apps have had this forever, but you can now take pictures with filters directly applied in the camera app. You can just click on the top right icon with the three circles, and it will bring up a bunch of different options. But unlike most other apps, here you'll get a live preview of what the picture will look like, not just having to apply it afterwards. Personally, I probably wouldn't really use this because I would rather just keep the original so I can adjust it later, but maybe if you really love filters, you'll like this. Next, number 8 is another quick camera feature, and that is the new live photo effects. These new options are called loop, bounce, and long exposure, and these were also kind of taken from other apps, but whatever. To get to them, you go to any live photo in the Photos app and just swipe up. And they're pretty self-explanatory. The loop just loops it and tries to blend the beginning and end together. Bounce reverses the live photo at the end and then repeats that over and over so it looks like it's going back and forth. And long exposure actually creates a still image and combines all the live photo frames together into one that looks like a long exposure. I especially like that last one, and the good thing is you can change the effect if you want after the fact. All right, hold on. Before we go to number 9, here's another quick secret camera feature Apple hasn't even really talked about. Now, when you hold your camera directly facing down, like to take a picture of a document or a receipt or whatever, a little set of crosshairs will appear. And this is basically a level, and when you line up the two crosshairs, it means that you're aimed directly down, so you'll get less distortion on whatever you're taking a picture of. It's pretty neat. Okay, back to number 9. I don't know if you'd really call this a feature, but whatever. It's a complete redesign of the App Store. Most notably, there are now dedicated tabs at the bottom to distinguish between apps and games, and there's another tab called Today, where Apple will post different stuff like featured apps, tips and tricks, tutorials, that sort of thing. I guess that would be kind of nice if you're bored. You can just go there and check to see if there's anything new and cool, new apps to check out, or whatever. Coming near the end, number 10 is AirPlay 2. It actually contains a bunch of features like being able to add speakers to your HomeKit app and playing music to multiple speakers at once. This makes sense, especially since Apple is going to be releasing their HomePod speaker in the near future, and it seems like they'll be putting a little bit more effort into the home entertainment sector, which could turn out to be pretty cool. I'm definitely gonna be watching what they do with that. All right, finally, number 11, but actually I do have a bonus feature after this, so don't go away just yet. Anyway, number 11 is the Do Not Disturb While Driving feature. With this, your phone will try to automatically detect when you're driving, probably with GPS and the accelerometer, and will make it so you won't get any notifications during that time. It's optional, of course, though. There's also the option to have it automatically respond to any text messages you receive or just from your favorite contacts, and then saying in that response that you're driving and you can't respond right away. Of course, if you're not actually driving, you're a passenger, you can just tap the option when it comes up and it won't enable it. So I could definitely see this helping, assuming people actually start using it. Okay, we're not done yet. We have something extra because I also wanted to mention the new Augmented Reality or AR kit abilities in iOS 11. This isn't something that has a settings menu anywhere. It's just kind of built into the background. Basically, Apple has made it a lot easier for developers to make augmented reality apps, and there are already several out there that are pretty cool. For example, there's the IKEA app, which lets you look at furniture and see what it would look like if it was actually in your room. Using it, you can see here, you just pick up one of the things, you drag it around, put it wherever you want. And I was curious how true to size these things were, so I actually compared it to one of the little tables that I happen to have. And I found it to be actually pretty darn accurate, which was really impressive. Now, I did notice if you move around too much and change your perspective, it usually gets thrown off and will shift things, but it was still pretty close. So if you stay mostly in the same place, you should get something that will look pretty accurate. So I'm definitely gonna be keeping an eye on what new AR apps come out, and I think you should too. So that's it, a bunch of cool new features for iOS, maybe a few that you didn't even know about before. And if you know any other super secret features that I didn't mention, be sure to let everyone know down in the comments section and check down there as well. If you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. And if you want to subscribe, I make a few new videos every week. And also consider enabling notifications by hitting the bell, or YouTube literally will not show you the new videos anyway. It's kind of a stupid system. But again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.